Hello. I'm a bit embarrassed to be back here today after yesterday's haircutting debacle. Though I'm actually quite happy with the haircut. I was joking with someone in the comments that I didn't really plan it out very well, but my kind of introduction on YouTube was me in my dressing gown with no makeup and then videoing myself in the least flattering poses with the least flattering hairstyles known to man. But I guess it's all good, keeping it real. Anyway, today I'm going to swatch out the second half of my acrylic gouache paints from Holbein. These are the ones I did a couple of days ago, and I'll just follow the same format today. So, in the left-hand box, we have the colour as it comes straight out of the tube. And then I'm adding in titanium white in different concentrations just to show what pastel shades we can get. I mean, obviously, you could mix each of these with black and get darker shades of all of these too. So I've put the first lot that I swatched the other day. I keep those in my box that the 36 came in and my additional ones. I just keep in this old tin and pull them out when I need them. I didn't mention as well the other day that the titanium white I always buy in larger quantities because I get through that the most. So Holbein gouache. I'm not sure how many of the range they do in these 40 milliliter size tubes. I'll go and check that after and put a note on the video. But the rest of them are all of these 20 mil size tubes. Okay, let's get swatching.
Not a star in the sky could steal your light. You are the diamond in the dark. No oceans out there can wash you away. There is no way that you can break. The good in you makes a better me and you easily. The best part I see, you're a fighter. You're a fighter.
Okay, that's them all swatched out now. So we'll just have a closer look at them. They do change colour slightly as they dry, like a regular gouache does. So I would say then that you probably wouldn't need ultramarine blue and ultramarine deep. They're really quite similar. The ultramarine deep has a more intense shade straight out of the tube. So if you had that and the titanium white, you could probably dispense with the ultramarine blue. If we look at some of the, oops. Louis Greens. I'd say that the pale aqua is Let's have a look. It's probably most similar to the peacock blue. So if you had peacock blue and kept mixing with titanium white, you'd probably get quite close to the pale aquas. It's ever so slightly more blue, the pale aqua is, but not too much. Yes, maybe it's somewhere in between the peacock blue and the turquoise blue, actually, the pale aqua. And then I'd say, I really love this deep magenta. It's nice. I'd say that the pale lavender probably carries on as you mix blue violet with the titanium white. So if you had the blue violet, unless you want it as a convenience colour, you wouldn't need the pale lavender. And the pale lilac, again, I'd say carries on from the red violet, if you carried on mixing it with titanium white. These ash colours are really nice. And then looking at the black and greys, the neutral grey is definitely a warmer grey than you get by mixing the jet black with the titanium white. And I think the neutral grey probably continues on quite nicely from the neutral grey 2, you can carry on from the neutral grey 3 if you just mix that with titanium white. So yeah, there's a few there which you can make yourself easily enough. So if you have the acrylic gouache as well, let me know if there's any colours that you really like using, that either of the ones I've got here or the ones which I don't have from the range. I'll do another sketch now to finish off with.
Not a star in the sky could steal your light. You are the diamond in the dark. No oceans out there can wash you away. There is no way that you can break. The good in you makes a better me, and you're easily the best part I see. You're a fighter.
But I see.
So just a simple little gouache painting that I fancy doing. And I got that from this book here, Get Started with Gouache by Emma Block. There's a nice little step-by-step tutorial on this painting in there. And they're the materials that I used. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.